Hey guys, welcome to chapter 8. My thought is that you are preparing for your chapter 7 test. So this will be in waiting for you when you're done with your test on Thursday. You can jump right into chapter 8, applications of trigonometry. Looking at the syllabus here, it looks like we only have 4 sections in chapter 8, so we're going to get through this kind of quickly, and then we'll jump right into chapter 11. So today we are talking about applications of trigonometry. Our first section is called the law of sines. I won't be able to finish everything I have to say in the first lecture, so it will definitely have at least 2 parts. So a few reminders going into this. All triangles have 6 parts, 3 angles and 3 sides. The sum of all angles in any triangle equals 180 degrees. Pythagorean theorem only applies to right triangles. So what we are now investigating is triangles that are not right triangles, and how can we solve those? A triangle is considered solved if you know the lengths of all 3 sides and the measures of all 3 angles. So that is our goal, to solve. Not, although this method works for any triangle, the Pythagorean theorem only works for right triangles, so we need to have alternate methods to solve triangles that are not right triangles. So in order to solve a triangle, we need to know at least 3 of the 6 parts. So when you have your triangle, so we have any triangle, we don't know the measure of any of the angles. We typically use lowercase letters to represent the sides of the triangle. So here's side A, here's side B, here's side C. Opposite the side that we call A, we usually call that angle A, just for to kind of minimize confusion. Or we can use our Greek letters, alpha, beta, and gamma. So I'm just gonna use capital A for this angle, for simplicity. The angle opposite side B, I'm gonna call angle B, and the angle opposite side C, I'll call capital C. So there's our triangle. It can be any shape, any size. Angles opposite sides typically have the same letter, one lowercase, one uppercase. Side B, opposite angle, capital B. Side C, opposite angle, capital C. So we need to know at least 3 of these 6 parts, and we have to know the length of one of the sides in order to solve a triangle. Because of similar triangles, we can have 2 angles or 2 triangles that have exactly the same angle measure, but have completely different lengths of sides. So similar triangles have all same angle measures. So if you were only given the 3 angle measures, there would be infinitely many triangles that would solve that. And we're not going to look at that scenario. All right, so that being said, we first want to identify triangles in order to decide what method to use to solve the triangle. So case 1, what do we know? We call case 1, different books call them different things. I'm just calling this case 1 is when we know one side and 2 angles. So in that situation, one side and 2 angles, well, we may know the side that's sandwiched between the 2 angles, or we may know the side that is not sandwiched between the 2 angles. So what do I mean by that? Well, let's draw a triangle, just any random triangle so we can classify this guy. All right, so let's suppose we know the length of this side. And let's suppose we don't know this angle, but we know this angle and we know this angle. So in this case, we would call this the included side because it is the side that falls between the 2 known angles. So we know an angle. If we go around this triangle, we start at any piece that we know when we go around the triangle. We know an angle, then we know the included side, and then we know another angle. It's included because it's the side we call this, the included side. Since it's between the 2 known angles. This type of triangle is called an angle side angle triangle. So A for angle, S for side, and then an angle. So when we write it this way, and we see the S falling between the two A's, we're getting a triangle when we know the side that's included. And this does matter. It's going to help us in our solving technique. So it's an angle, side, triangle. So side between two known angles. So we call this an angle, side, angle, triangle. Now the other scenario for knowing one side and two angles, if we didn't know this side, and let's suppose we knew either the side over here on the left or the side on top of the triangle. If we knew this side or that side, notice because we don't know this angle, the known side would not be sandwiched between the two known angles. And we call that a side angle angle or an angle angle side. So let's write that down. So case 1A, we should say, this is 1A. In case 1B is we also know, so still known, 1 side and 2 angles, but this time the side is not included. So we know 2 angles, let's suppose we know angle A and angle B. Last time we knew the included side, this time we're going to know either one of these sides. So let's suppose we know the side here opposite. So I call this little a because it's opposite of angle A. So this is called A. If we go around, we know an angle, and then we know the side. So we call this an angle, angle side, or a side, angle, angle. So notice the side, the S, is not between the two A's representing the angles because the side does not fall between the new angles, the two known angles. So this is a angle, angle side, or a side, angle, angle. We would typically, if the side known was this one, we would call it a side, angle, angle, but it doesn't matter. All we need to know is that we know two angles and one side, and if you know two angles and one side, it's either an angle side angle triangle, and if it's an angle side triangle, angle side angle triangle, the side we know is sandwiched between the two known angles. If it's an angle angle side, then the side that's known is not sandwiched between the two angles. So let's write that down here, known side is not between the two known angles. All right, so let's classify. Let's look at case two. Case two is when we know two sides and a non-included angle. When we know two sides and a non-included angle, so let's suppose we know this side and we know this side. This would be my included angle because it falls between the two known sides, but I'm saying that's not the scenario we are looking at. We're going to look at either this angle or that angle. Let's suppose we know this angle right here. So when I call the angle B because it's opposite side B. So this is an example of knowing two sides and a non-included angle. Okay. Or we could do we know A and B, but we know angle A instead. So two sides and a non-included angle. All right, this case, we call this a side, side, angle, or an angle, side, side. Side, side, angle, or angle, side, side. We call it either one because we don't put the A between the two S's. because the angle does not fall between the two known sides. So it's a side-side angle or an angle side-side triangle. Known angle. Is not between the two known sides. So an SSA or an ASS triangle would be case two. Case three is when we know two sides and the included angle. So if we know two sides, but this angle is the one in between those two known sides, that's called a side angle side triangle. So that's case three. And there, it does make a difference on how we solve these triangles. So case three is known two sides and an included angle. Oops, overshot that one. Excuse my little warped triangle. So let's suppose we know side A and side B. We would now know the included angle. Oops, let me call that B, like I said. So this would be angle B, this would be angle A, so this would be angle C. So the known angle is in between the two known sides. So this is called side angle side triangle. So known angle is between the two known sides. No other way to write it, just side, angle, side. And then the last case, the simplest one to recognize when you know all three sides of the triangle, but don't know any angles. So case four, in our last case, all triangles fall into one of these four cases. You know all three sides, but don't know any of the angles. So you know A, B, and C. So this is called a side, side, side triangle. All angles are unknown. So cases one and two are angle side angle triangles. That is, we know two angles in the included side. Or we know two angles in the non-included side, that would be the side angle angle and the angle angle side triangle. Or we know one angle and it is not between the two known sides. So the SSA, side side angle, or the angle side side. So there's five triangles that make up cases one and two. There's only two triangles that make up case three and four. Cases one and two, what they all have in common is that we use the law of sines to solve these. Cases three and four, we're going to use the law of cosines. So you might be thinking these are lots of little acronyms to remember and how can I keep it all straight? Well, the trick is, in order to use the law of sines, all you need to know is you have to know at least one angle and the side opposite to that angle. If you can look, draw the picture and look at it, and you know, let me write that down, an angle and the side opposite of that angle, then you can use the law of sines. If you don't have an angle and its side opposite, then you have to use the law of cosines. So use law of sines when you know at least one angle and its and its opposite side's length. I feel like my grammar is a little bit horrible there, but so let's just go back quickly and look at cases 1 and 2, and we can see in cases 1 and 2, here in case 1, an angle-angle side or side-angle-angle, you'll always know one angle and the side opposite of it. So case 1, whoops, yep, that would be 1B, but still the same. Here we know side A. It doesn't look like we know angle A, but because we know two angles inside of the triangle, we can immediately find the third angle by adding these two together and subtracting it from 180. So if you know two angles, immediately find the third angle, then you will know the side and the angle opposite of it. So both case 1A and case 1B, we know an angle and the side opposite, so we're gonna use the law of sines. In case 2, if we know two sides and the non-included angle, if you know two sides and the non-included angle, you automatically know one side and the angle opposite of it. In case 3 and 4, here we don't know angle B, and there's only one angle, so there's no way we can quickly find angle B. We know side A, we don't know angle A, and we don't know angle C, so we would use the law of cosines for this case. And case 4, when you know all three sides, clearly you don't know any angles, so we can't use the law of sines. All right, so, to be continued. See part 2. See you in a couple minutes.